Multiplying rational expressions is pretty straightforward. Your job is to factor both the tops and bottoms of each fraction. Then, to multiply them, you're going to do top times top and bottom times bottom. After that, there's going to be some canceling to do. You can cancel one thing from the top and bottom as long as they match. I'll show you what I mean in just a second. First, we've got to factor both the top and bottom. In this first expression, I can pull 2 out of both of those. That's called common factoring, and I'm left with x minus 4 once I do. The x plus 3 can't be factored further, so I leave it as x plus 3. I like using dots for multiplication in rational expressions because I don't want to get confused with my x's, but that's just me. This factors by difference of squares. That's x minus 3 and x plus 3. And this also common factors out. I can divide both of them by 12. So I put 12 in front of my bracket and divide both of those by 12 to give 12x minus 4. Now when I multiply top times top and bottom times bottom, I end up with 2 times x minus 4 times x minus 3 times x plus 3. Keep all your factors separate, but they're all multiplied together. And my bottom has a 12 and an x plus 3 and an x minus 4. Now, I'm allowed to cancel my x minus 4s because there's one of each in the top and bottom. That's 1 and 1 canceling. X plus 3 on bottom and top, one of each cancels. And actually this 2 and 12 can cancel. If you divide that by 2, it cancels to 1. If you divide that by 2, it cancels to 6, which gives me a final answer of just x minus 3 over 6. That's it. This is the simplified or multiplied and simplified rational expression. I'm supposed to state restrictions. X is not allowed to be, and I have to look throughout and see what things ever appeared on bottom. Here in the original, x could not have been negative 3. If x was negative 3, you'd be dividing by 0, and that's not okay. Here, x can't have been positive 4. That's more apparent here. Nothing else was ever on the bottom of a fraction, so these are the only two restrictions, and this is our final answer. But again, let's emphasize, you're factoring everything, multiplying top times top and bottom times bottom to make one mega fraction answer, and then canceling as much as possible before you state your restrictions. Shall we do it again? Yes, we shall. Let's factor this together. I'm looking for two numbers that multiply to 6 and add to negative 5. That's going to be x minus 2 and x minus 3. My bottom here, it's nothing special there, it's just x plus 2. I'm going to multiply that by, I think I can pull out a common 10 here. That's x squared minus 4. Well, that's going to factor even more by difference of squares. And on bottom, I have a negative 21. Let's see, that's going to factor to x minus 7. And x plus 3. I was looking for two numbers that multiplied to negative 21 and added to positive 4. Oh no, it's positive 7 and negative 3. Oh, I almost made a brutal error there. My top here can't factor anymore, but my bottom has 5 as a common factor, so I'm gonna take it out, divide both of them by 5, I get x minus 2. Cool! All right, now I'm going to do top times top times top. I have x minus 2, x minus 3. I have an extra 10. This x squared minus 4 factors more by difference of squares. That's x minus 2 and x plus 2. And I have an extra x plus 7 left over too. Wow, that's 6 things on top. It's a wild life we're living. I have an x plus 2 on bottom here. An x plus 7, an x minus 3, and a 5, and an x minus 2. Let's just be careful when we cancel here. X plus 2 will cancel with x plus 2. Great. X plus 7 will cancel with x plus 7. X minus 3 cancels with x minus 3. 5 cancels with 10 a little bit. and I have an x minus 2 on bottom, but it can only cancel with one of the x minus 2s on top. You can't cancel both of them. You can only cancel one at a time. So this x minus 2 cancels, and I'm going to choose this one. Wow, I have nothing left on bottom. Now that's technically 1 left on bottom, because when you divide by 1, nothing happens. But what I actually have here is 2 times x minus 2, and that's it for my simplified rational expression. What's going to be more interesting here is the restrictions. I can look at the bottom of my mega fraction and see x was not allowed to be negative 2, or negative 7, or positive 3. Oh, that doesn't have an x in it, so I don't use it, or positive 2. Wow, that's 4 restrictions. And this is my multiplied rational expression. I've simplified it to simply 2 times x minus 2. It's pretty wild. But don't forget to multiply. All you've got to do is factor everything. Use top times top and bottom times bottom. And then you can cancel one of each of the factors, or like as many as possible, but only one at a time, just so you don't, you know, get lost. Don't forget to state your restrictions in the end as well. Not too bad. My quickest rational expression video yet, probably because multiplying rationals is so easy. Hey, best of luck to you.